So, next review of the day is going to be for the film Damsel. This is a Netflix film. This is starring Millie Bobby Brown here. Here you have, of course, Damsel, who is Millie Bobby Brown, who's played Elodie. Here is her name there. So very much following, you see this kind of fantasy kingdom type setting here. And she's being married off, betrothed to this other prince, very handsome prince, and being, you know, accepted into this family. And as soon as when she kind of, you know, is accepted in this family, gets married to this family, things go awry. You know, she learns that, oh, things are not as they seem. And they basically just, like you see in the trailer, chuck her ass down a giant hole because she's meant as a sacrifice to this dragon that's living down there because this family that she's being married into owes this debt to the dragon there because the family killed the children of the dragon. So they have to have this debt there. They have to feed this dragon constantly there with the, you know, the bodies of all these kind of people who the dragon thinks is eating the other children of the family here. So it's a lot of a story about Millie Bobby Brown, which a lot of the focus is on her fighting this dragon, escaping, and then also taking on this evil kind of family. So, you know, you look at the cast, this is a very kind of, you know, got some noticeable names in here. You see Robin Wright is in here. Robin Wright, people might know her. She was in, you know, she had a voice work in Beowulf. She was also in Unbreakable. She was also in Princess Bride. She was also in House of Cards, too, with Kevin Spacey. She was also in that. Angela Bassett is in this. She's the stepmother there of Millie Bobby Brown and her sister. We just talked about stepmother, black stepmother. I guess that must be a thing that this year. We talked about that with DeWanda Wise and Imaginary. But she's the stepmother there to Millie Bobby Brown and her sister. And then the husband, who's the father of the two young daughters, is Ray Winstone there, who's the one that clears the deal, who allows Millie Bobby Brown to, you know, be married off there and says, okay, yeah, I agree. And we can go ahead and get started here. This movie, I mean, if you remember the segment of like, because this is a talking dragon as well. And if you remember the segment I said, I said in a Letterboxd review of something like The Hobbit, where, you know, it's Bilbo and he's, you know, has that confrontation with Smaug, that it's kind of like most of the movie is that, where she's, you know, running from this dragon and talking to this dragon and trying to escape. But it's a lot less interesting. It's way 10 times less interesting than that you saw in something like The Hobbit, which I thought was one of the better sequences of that entire film. In the second Desolation of Smaug, where he actually encounters the dragon and they have the whole back and forth. And voice of the dragon, I swear I can look up the voice real quick, but it's someone that I definitely know who the voice of the dragon is. I probably know who the actress is. That kind of segment there, I mean, the effects look good with the dragon. I think that looks really good when they do that. And when she's actually fighting it, it actually looks pretty good. Everything else is not interesting all that much. Everything else is, it doesn't really feel, you know, really that attached to the story. I don't feel that attached to the story, the environments and everything like that. It's a lot of these kind of Netflix type things where it's like very plain, very doesn't really feel the world, doesn't really feel lived in, feels very clean and sanitized there. I think that, you know, Millie Bobby Brown trying to do more of a, you know, fantasy adventure type story here. It kind of works. I think, she, you know, maybe in a better movie, I think she could, because I think Millie Bobby Brown is a talented actress. Outside of other things like Stranger Things, like when she was like in Alona Holmes, I actually like the Alona Holmes movies. I think those are pretty fun. You know, if you give her some good, smart, fun, you know, material, I think she can work and can do well there. It's just that this movie, I don't think he's really doing anything for her. This movie's directed by Juan Carlos. Now, Juan Carlos, I haven't seen any of his other things here. He did Intruders, which I haven't seen, and he also did 28 Weeks Later, which I also haven't seen there. But I heard 28 Weeks Later was rather decent, I heard that was actually pretty good. So this is on Netflix. You can watch it at home. I think out of the many, many options on Netflix, I think you can find something better there to watch than this. Josh just dropped off with me there. But let me finish this review. But yeah, you can find, I think, something better to watch there on Netflix to watch than this. And Radiant and Patrice said, best Millie Bobby Brown performance, I still think, is The Intruders, where she was 11 years old and had to play a 500-year-old serial killer. I haven't seen that. So I guess it's a reuniting of the director and actor here, because that same director also did Intruders. So I guess it's a reuniting between them. Yeah, I think that, like I said, many other better options to watch on Netflix than this. I don't think it's really that engaging. It's just nothing besides, hey, it's a cool dragon and the dragon can talk. And isn't that kind of fun? I think that's about it. That's all going to get from it. I do like her kind of fighting back a little bit and surviving and trying to, you know, using her wits to, you know, get out of things. But that's really about, that's really the only thing going for this movie, is just the dragon pieces. Nothing really outside of that that's that interesting. Have you heard anything about this movie, Josh?
I have heard some mixed reactions to it. Some people don't love the movie. Some people do like this movie. I've heard.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm kind of seeing. I saw that kind of before. A lot of mixed reactions on it.
And you have a pretty good.
Yeah. I think you say, yeah. I think Josh was going to say, you have a pretty good cast here. You do have a good cast in this movie here. It's just they don't really do anything.
Millie Bobby Brown, Ray Winstone, who I've seen in stuff like Beowulf. Angela Bassett, of course, very famous. What's Love Got to Do with It? And Boys in the Hood and Black Panther and such. Robin Wright, of course. Jenny from Forrest Gump. Fincher's version of Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. The Wonder Woman movies. Lots of stuff.
Yeah.
And you do have a genre that it is probably my favorite. It is probably my favorite genre.
In fantasy?
In terms of fantasy. Since I am a fan of fantasy, like Harry Potter and The Lord of the Rings, and I am a defender of the Hobbit trilogy, even with its problems, but I don't know. It's just, I would probably check this out if I to do a 2024 catch up review part one of what's been out so far, as a Twitch stream or such, because I do like doing the Twitch stream, but like I said, I'm not gonna abandon the filmed side while I use my cameras. But
I mean, if you want to check it out, I think, you know, there's some kind of okay moments here, like I mentioned with the dragon kind of stuff. I think that's the most interesting stuff. That's kind of about it. Everything else is just kind of meh around it. You know, Millie Bobby Brown's trying to raise a profile, trying to be a little bit more of a big star, trying to be in leading woman in more things now.
Which I will give Millie a lot of credit for that. Wanting to step out of her traditional thing. I think that's what each cast member of the Stranger Things should do, especially Maya Hawke and Kelly McLaughlin, Finn Wolfhard. Also, Sadie Sink, hoping she gets to do more stuff to where she can branch out from the character of Max. But I respect Millie for doing that.
Yeah. So I just don't think this is a good opportunity. I don't think this is the best movie to show that there, even though she is decent in it. So for me, I would give it maybe a low stream it for me, kind of a low stream territory, and people can watch it there. And I think it also is a movie that tries to kind of have more of a, because, you know, it is damsel, and the movie opens up with the narration from Millie Bobby Brown about the whole, you know, damsel in distress, and she's the one that kind of saves herself and tries to have a little bit of that in this movie there, which I think is kind of clunky and kind of not as well executed there, and doesn't feel like it plays that much of a role in the movie all that much, that even though she does save herself, it's just like, I don't know. I don't feel like it plays that much of a role there.
Yeah, I think a movie that I think did this better, which is unfortunately not on streaming services anymore, you have to find this on a free movie website, is The Princess with Joey Keane. It was a Hulu movie in 2022, which I really enjoyed. And you had Joey King starring in it and also producing it. And I thought it was a pretty cool little movie. It wasn't something groundbreaking, but I thought for the premise that you had, Joey King is beautiful as he is, also fine as hell, kicking ass. And I definitely did enjoy that. It has problems with the villain and some of the writing, but if anything, seeing that in Bullet Train made me say Joey King should be capable. She should do more action. Because she is pretty good at it. So I think that movie did it better. Like I said, unfortunately, it's not on Hulu anymore. It is available for YouTube to watch or rent, as long with another Hulu movie I think should both The Princess and Rosaline with Caitlin Dever should be released on physical media, as well as Caitlin's last movie, No One Will Save You, which was great. But yeah, The Princess, I think, did it a lot better, even yeah, with its problems.
Yeah, I heard a lot of comparisons to The Princess there, who I think Nick, I think he did a review of The Princess, or he said he liked it quite a bit, actually, that film. So yeah, I did hear a lot of comparisons to that movie when talking about a damsel with other people there. That was like, yeah, The Princess probably did it better there. But shame they took it off of Hulu there. You know, that people can't watch it there.
Yeah, trying to say tax refunds, which is bullshit. You just took it off because you didn't want people to watch it. The least you could do is put it on physical media. Put all your freaking Hulu movies on physical media. I would not have a problem having No One Will Save You on there. Especially yeah, for Caitlin Dever's performance, which I honestly think, like I said, I think she's going to be a great Abby. If anyone tries to bully her, at least she's not going to stand for it.
Yeah. So like I said, you know, for all those reasons I just said, that's why I kind of give it a low stream it to... I don't know. Maybe skip it territory. I go skip it, maybe. Yeah, kind of like there. Because like I said, I think there's other better things you could be watching on Netflix other than this, even when you are kind of streaming it. So, and as good as, you know, some of the segment is with the dragon, it's like, it's not that worth it. So, I give it a skip it instead for me. So, yeah, that was my review of Damsel.